boss, and you're frustrated but afraid to take the next step? Are you someone who won't take risks and prefer to stay safe? Are you the type of person who wouldn't to another person if they say they want to go it alone? Do you lack the necessary funding to begin your business, and so you do nothing? It's time to face your fears, understand how good you are in business, and why you should seriously consider going it alone. We'll show you how your talent, even an enjoyable hobby, can be your ticket to financial independence and a more prosperous future. So stay with us as we present the basics to help you mind your business in 2013 on tonight's Delia Factor Live.
Are those of the host and guest, and in no way represent those of DBS, and are not intended to determine decision-making processes. Delia Factor Live is brought to you compliments of Ferrens Dairy, Court St. Lucia, Glass Graphics, Carz for Rent, Transit TV, Star Publishing, Touch Therapies, Vision Express, Infinity Color Shop.
Hello and welcome to Delia Factor Live. I'm Delia Delia. In these hard economic times, more than ever before, many of us struggle to make ends meet. How unemployed people cope, I just don't know. But even when someone is employed nowadays, there's a constant worry that their job isn't secure. The signs are all around us. What can we do to secure our financial future? And I'm not talking about savings, I'm talking about providing you and your family with an income you can control. On tonight's program, we ask you to mind your business and try to put something else in place that can supplement your income and perhaps even become your income. In the studio tonight, Jermile Daniel of The Cell, who was named Entrepreneur of the Year at the 2013 St. Lucia Business Awards, and Kurt ELIBOX of Blueprint Construction, who won the Young Entrepreneur of the Year Award. Welcome, gentlemen. Welcome to Delia Factor Live.
Thank you.
We have a lot of expectations from our viewers tonight, most of them in fear because, as I said earlier in the introduction, the economic world is changing constantly, and people are getting worried in terms of their own jobs and whether it's time for them to perhaps look at creating jobs for themselves, and then still worried that if they do that, where's the money coming to come from? So we're going to be looking at that tonight, and we really hope that both of you will be able to help us with that. We will be joined later by Marcellus Joseph, the manager of the James Belgrave Micro Enterprise Development Fund, BELFUND. Now, gentlemen, what's your desired result at the end of tonight's show? Jermile, can I ask you first?
Well, I would like to educate as many people as possible in terms of the benefits of being an entrepreneur, and motivate as many individuals as I can to go out there and turn your hobby or your passion into a venture that can actually support you, can create employment for others as well. You mentioned that, you know, we're in very challenging economic times, and you know it's a perfect time to actually try to change that hobby into a venture that can actually sustain you, can sustain your family, and make some sort of economic contribution to the society at large.
Good. I'm really looking forward to you kind of helping to put the viewers on the right track and motivating as well. Kurt, what do you hope for tonight?
By the end of tonight, hopefully stimulate the minds of young persons like myself, get them a bit enticed, excited about going into their own business, or those who currently have jobs, get them to probably take their jobs a bit more seriously. Just educate them about the ins and outs of business, letting them know how the ins, the outs, how difficult it's going to be. It's really not an easy road.
Okay, great. I'm sure that between the three of us, we're going to try our best. All right, so of course it's time for two in a row, and where our viewers know, we're going to ask a question to our guests, so something that's totally unrelated to tonight's show. So, Kurt, I'm going to actually start with you now. What was the naughtiest thing that you got away with when you were at school?
naughtiest.
See, there's so many, you have to start thinking, which one do I want to tell St. Lucia?
okay. Probably one of the naughtiest things at school was, honestly, cheating.
Cheating in what way?
An exam.
Oh, a naughty.
Class exam. And I actually had the paper of a colleague of mine. Mm-hmm. Slipped it under the desk. The teacher kind of just turned his back for a second. Mm-hmm. She slipped it and she was like the brain of the class. You know, it was something to do with mathematics.
Okay.
It's not one of my strong areas. She kind of just slipped the paper under the desk. And the teacher was just walking around and he's like, why you have two papers? And I was like, so I don't know. And honestly, I think that he was in a very good mood and he just said, here's your paper. He gave it to the girl and she said, here's your paper, and he said, don't let it happen again. That was it.
And did you do it again? That means yes. That's a yes. All right, well, thank you. No tomorrow that several people are going to have different names for you. But thank you for sharing that with us. Jermile, tell us one memory that always brings a smile to your face.
One memory that brings a smile, always brings a smile to my face, would have to be, I'm a Sumerian, a former Sumerian, and I can remember when we won the basketball championship in 1993, and I was actually captain of the school team at the time, and it's a memory that, you know, always brings back great smiles, great memories as well.
Oh, great. Yeah. Oh, that's nice. I was at St. Mary's College last week for the Nobel Laureate, mm-hmm. The Honourable Derek Walker lecture. And I have to say, in all the years, because my brother used to go there, we used to just drop him at the gate. I'd never been into the college. So it took me, I'm not saying how many years, but decades to actually go into the college. And lots of proud people from SMC were there. So I can just imagine
that's
how
right,
you felt.
Yeah.
Great. Well, as we go to the break, this week's Delor Factor fan is Cleopatra Ishmael. And you can learn more about Cleopatra on DelorFactorLive.com. Great girl. And our picture on set is called Fishing. It's by Jonathan Gladding, and it's available from the Inner Gallery on the Waterwash Hideaway. Now, we have one giveaway tonight, plus a reminder of our Valentine's treats for you. And I say one, it's actually coming from one person, but there are actually lots of goodies coming there. Okay, now I will repeat them at the end of the show, as the winner for our Valentine's treats will be chosen on February the 7th, which is next week. The deadline for all these treats is February the 4th, that's this coming Monday. Now, listen to these. Treat one, tell us what you love most about your partner. The winner will receive a luxury Valentine treat called Indulge, which includes a candlelight Swedish massage together with a bottle of wine and chocolate cheesecake, courtesy of Touch Therapies. So to enter for treat one, tell us what you love most about your partner. Treat two, this is for those without a Valentine. Tell us who you'd like to have dinner with and why. It can be a friend, a neighbor, a personality, and we will set it up. Now, four viewers will win a three-course meal and a glass of wine at a choice of four top restaurants. Chart House in Rodney Bay, Chef Xavier, and Spice of India in Baywalk Mall, or Rainforest Hideaway in Marigot. That's treat two. If you haven't got a Valentine, tell us who you'd like to have dinner with and why. It can be a friend, a neighbor, personality, and provided they want to have dinner with you, we'll make it happen. Treat three, we're asking you to create a dessert using Ferran's ice cream, especially for Valentine's. The best recipe will receive a three-course meal at Orlando's in Sufra. You'll also receive a courtesy car from Carz for Rent so you can get there. And when you arrive, you will notice that your dessert creation is included on Chef Orlando's Valentine menu. When you leave, you'll receive ice cream from Ferran. So that's treat three challenge. It's to create a Valentine's dessert using Ferran's ice cream. The winner will be announced on February the 7th. Treat four. Name two of the prizes in Super J's IGI and TJ's Valentine's promotion. It's a love thing. And you can win a fantastic Valentine basket. The winner will be chosen live at Super J's Sunny Acres store on Monday, the 11th February at 1 p.m. And a little bird tells me there are some day passes at luxury hotels and some edible Valentine treats. The deadline is 9 a.m. on the 11th of February. Now, tonight's giveaway is a $100 gift certificate from The Cell. For your chance to win, name four products you can purchase at The Cell and tell us what they are, okay? We want you to tell us those four products and also what is an equity fund. All right, now for that, there is a separate prize and Jermile will tell you about that later. All right, but for tonight, can you just tell us four products that you can buy at The Cell and what is an equity fund? There are two questions there. You can answer either one or both of them. As always, the questions are on DolorFactorLive.com and Facebook, Dolor Factor Live TV show. After the break, we're going to talk about business. Are you scared to start one? Are you ready to start one? Do you have support to start one? Lots of things we're going to talk about tonight, and you know we're here to help. So don't forget, you know how to contact us. Stay with DBS and Dolor Factor Live. We'll be right back after the break.